I'm quite upset now because I was just walking to the train station to go and see my friends in a nearby town, and on the way to the station, I live in the middle of like an old Victorian housing estate, and I was walking down the road on the phone, and then I noticed in the corner of my eye a little baby, what I thought was a duckling or a baby swan, walking around down the road, like calling out for its mum. And there were a couple of people around, they were just looking at it and kind of smiling as if it was funny. But I saw that it was lost, and it wasn't near water. It was obviously a water bird of some kind, because it had the little three toes with the flap thing in between. I'm not an ornithologist, but I don't know what it's called. But I could see this little baby was lost anyway, because it was just walking, waddling down the road, calling out for its mom. So I thought, well, I can't just get on the train and leave it, because I just feel awful. So I tried to go over to him, or her. I'll say him, I'll call it him. I tried to go over and pick him up so I could take him back to the nearest water, which is a canal that's near my estate. But he was a bit scared of me, so he kept waddling off. Obviously, I could easily catch up with him, because he was tiny, couldn't fly or anything. But I didn't want to scare him, so I just followed him slowly and was talking in a very gentle voice, saying, "It's okay, I'm going to help you get home." And then, at this point, people like hanging out their windows, smoking and whatever, looking at me and laughing, but I just thought, fuck them. And the little baby then went down like a little back alley, down between some of these houses, and started waddling off over these old used mattresses and needles and whatever else is down there. So I followed him down there. Eventually it went round a corner to a dead end, and he kind of knew he couldn't go anywhere. So he just, it was the saddest thing, he didn't put up a fight or anything like that. He sort of just collapsed, sunk down onto his knees and put his wings out like that, as if to just say, "I don't want to be here, I'm hiding from everything." So I picked him up, gently just like scooped him up on hands. I don't know how to pick up a bird. So I just sort of cradled his, put my hands under his torso and put my thumbs up over his wings so he couldn't flap his wings or hurt himself. And he started kind of squawking pathetically, like he thought I was going to kill him or something, and he wanted his mum to come and help him. There was nothing I could do, so then I gently carried him back down through the different roads in my estate, down to the canal. There were some kids looking, "Look at that bird, look at that bird!" Guy with a dog barking at him. This thing must have been petrified. Well, I got back to the canal anyway, and I gently placed him down on the grass verge next to the water. At this point, a couple of other people walking down the canal saw me with him, and they were like interested in what was going on. So we sat there, as we stood there next to this little baby. He didn't know what to do. He was just kind of ambling around, still looking for his mummy. He wouldn't go in the water. He started walking off down the road, so I tried ringing the RSPB on my phone, found the number online, but it just put me into like a call, was it RSPCA or RSPB? I tried both of them anyway. I think it was the RSPB just had an out of hours thing, so because it's a weekend. RSPCA then put me on this automated phone line, which was just a complicated maze of options, like, "For domestic animals that have been trapped in a snare, press 1. For badgers that have a missing leg, press 2. For worms that have been chopped in half, press 3. And I just lost in this maze of options. And in the end it just said, "Why not go on our website and speak to our artificial intelligence bot, Annie," or something. And then it just hung up on me. I thought, piece of shit, I've got a lost animal here. So then I rang the local vets. And they told me that I ought to try picking the thing up and like bringing it to them to see if it was okay. But while I was on the phone to them, a guy walked past with a dog. And the dog ran up to the duckling. Luckily, it didn't attack it or anything, but it was being quite investigative and playful, and the duck went over to the water. The guy moved his dog away, but anyway, the duck eventually... I don't know if it's a duck. I think it was a baby seagull in hindsight because of the sound it was making, and just the fact that it didn't look like a swan, duck, or moorhen. He plopped into the water, so I couldn't pick him up, and I knew he was still lost. He'd been tumbling over before as well, so I don't know whether he was injured. But anyway, he plopped into the water at this point while I was on the phone to the vet. And I said, well, look, I can't pick him up now. He's in the water. I didn't know if he was going to drown, if he was capable of swimming. Luckily, he kind of uprighted himself, and then he moved across to the other side of the canal where there was a moorhen kind of hanging about. And then this little baby moved over, swam over to the moorhen going, cheep, cheep, as if he was saying, help me. I'm looking for my mummy. And there was nothing I could do then. So I feel like this little guy was relying on me to help return him to his mummy. And I haven't done it. I've managed to get him back out of the estate to the water. And he clearly is a water bird, I guessed. I think it was a seagull. But now his fate is kind of out of my hands, really. I put him in the water and he swam off. I didn't see him. I didn't see any other seagulls or any other ducklings or whatever you call them that like him. So he's still on his own out there. And I don't know what's going to happen to the little fella. So I don't feel like catching the next train now to go and see my friends, because it kind of just really made me think how fragile everyone is when they're on their own. And how there are always people out there willing to help, but they can't always help you. So I'd say, I don't know, if you see someone who looks like they need help, whether it be a human or any other animal, just do what you can. And if you can't do anything, then don't stress about it, because you know you've tried to help.